aching cold sets into an unfamiliar body. A distant howling surrounds you, louder with each passing second. Insistent and invisible hands slap and tear at the membrane that protects you. Your first emotion is an involuntary and formless panic. You feel you have forgotten something, something important. As if it once meant the world to you, but the details slip away as you grasp at them. You force your eyes open. Your body is... wait, you are wearing a form-fitting suit of some dark material. You recall that you were wearing something much more elaborate a short time ago. You have smooth, light brown skin, 5 fingers on each hand, 5 toes on each foot. Good muscles, strong but not bulky, and slim hips. Your palms are soft, as if they have not done much labor, but scars and burns on the hands and wrists suggest that you haven't always been careful. Why can't you remember this? Without warning, the cocoon that surrounds you shreds and tears away. You are falling. Above you, a small moon is slowly collapsing in on itself. The world is many kilometers below you. You are spinning too rapidly to get a good look. You can see a large landmass, a vast body of water directly below you, and scattered archipelagos. But the detail eludes you. A deep black night is above you, its nocturnal clarity disappearing as the haze of atmosphere envelops you. You don't seem to have any other option. You close your eyes to the world below you. Ignore the rushing of the wind past you, and concentrate. You remember that you were in the hallways of a place that wove itself through your blood, through your thoughts. The memories project themselves in your mind, a story told to you as if they happened to someone else. Yet it was your body that walked those halls, your lungs that breathed that air. You were running because something was hunting you, a nightmare far more powerful than you. You were... Who? Who were you? Nothing for you to grab hold of, and the resistance of your body can only do so much against the insistent grasp of the earth. As you vainly try to grasp at the air, cupping your hands, you can see the watery grave that lies ahead of you. Wait, you plummet toward a dome structure of glass or crystal floating in a bay, and a strangely blurred woman and a man are pointing at you. A mass of colors rushes from his outstretched arm, enfolding you, but it's too late. You were falling too fast. With a sick darkness.
All right. Let's go. I'm ready. Yes, now. Yes. I can breathe again.
Where did she fall from? Her body's smashed to talc. It's a wonder she's still breathing.
All I saw was the corona, not her origin point. But look, she's healing already. Spontaneous regeneration.
I'll remember that.
I need to talk to you.